This is Lester.
Chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow.
The city of clouds, the most of its visible event is King and Queen. In the city of clouds.
Hall Square. The town hall and the square were built on the site of the old cattle market in 1875, and for the next 100 years the city council conducted its business from this building. Before 1933, part of the building served as a police station, and the square was often referred to as Municipal Square by older Leicester people. Employment marches and riots in 1921.
Somebody threw a stone in Rupert Street through a window, through the Poor Law offices, where we used to go for Poor Law relief. And that started it.
Oh. I will remember them forming up in Woodboy Street, marching through to the town hall, and they tried to break in there, and as they held their meetings and raised their objection to unemployment, the police came running out of the police station and used their batons.
There were some in thousands, turned out with bricks and stones and besieged the police station.
Western Road, Leicester. The company's story goes back to 1886, when a group of workers in a shoe factory decided that they wanted to have their own factory where they could share in the profits. They formed the Leicester Cooperative Boot and Shoe Manufacturing Society Limited. By the spring of 1887, they had raised enough money to rent a small factory in Friars Causeway. 21 people began work, making women's shoes, largely by hand. By 1889, trade had grown so much that they were able to move to new premises in Bede Street. January 1895 saw the opening of the newly built Western Road factory, and by 1940 they were able to open a second factory in Grace Road. In 1958, the company changed its name to Equity Shoes Limited. 6 years later, the Grace Road factory was sold and a new extension was built at Western Road. Christmas 2008, the workers were called to this canteen to be told that the company was closing with immediate effect.
You must remember this, a kiss is-
just a kiss, a sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you, on that you can rely.
This state-of-the-art Victorian Tower brewery was designed by our founder's nephew, John Everard, and opened in 1875. It took William Everard 18 years before he bought his first pub. Today, we own over 165 pubs, trading in 10 counties. Realising the importance of Burton well water in the production of bitters, we started brewing here at the Burton Bridge Brewery in 1892. Our Burton beers became so popular, we moved production to this larger brewery in Anglesey Road, Burton-on-Trent, in 1898. The Leicester Brewery, built by the founder, was closed in 1932 as a direct result of the Chancellor of the Exchequer, Philip Snowden, increasing beer excise duty by one old penny per pint. Following the expansion of the company during the 60s and 70s, we moved to the Castle Acres site in 1982.
Bowstring Bridge that carried the main line across the Old Soar was constructed between 1896 and 1899 by civil engineers Henry Lovett of Wolverhampton. This sturdy bridge was designed to carry some of the heaviest locomotives seen on British rails. This was the main route into Leicester from the southwest. The Victorian town's coal-fueled industrial expansion combined with the slowly improving flood prevention measures that led to Broadstone Gate being filled with factories and homes for their workers from across the Soar. Edward Watkin, the visionary Victorian, was a chairman of railway companies in the north and south of Britain, and he conceived the Great Central Railway to link them. His obsession was to dig a tunnel under the English Channel so it would be possible to board a train in Leicester and alight in Venice just hours later. And this was 100 years ago. The idea of the line passing through Leicester Castle was strongly objected to by residents wishing to protect their ancient heritage. The new route involved the destruction of many new houses and factories. The ingenious design was fashioned from the best steel and the strongest bricks. Combined with the recently constructed Miles Strait, the area became an attraction for Sunday outings by the townsfolk. The bridge and the passing expresses quickly became integrated into a thriving community that was now part of the expanding city. Watkin's grand scheme that created the last and best designed mainline railway ran out of money early on. Due to the lavish expenditure on its construction and competition from established railway companies. Although it was never a commercial success, this well-graded, smooth, fast line continued to operate and was the best route in the country. It was only closed in the shocking beaching conspiracy in 1966, and it continued for another few years locally before the tracks were lifted, and eventually in the 1980s the track bed, including the bridge, was transformed into the visionary Great Central Way for pedestrians and cyclists.
People stop and stare, they don't bother me. There's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you are.